we recently announced our research program, which we call 6G Forward, and looking into six key aspects. First is new spectrum and topologies. Again, you know, with every new technology or every new generation of cellular, there's always talk about new spectrum. And Sean has shown a slide there from Ericsson, which is a great slide. What I'm most, I would say, excited about is this thing called upper midband, really the spectrum between 7 and 24 gigahertz. You know, sweet spot again of coverage and capacity, you know, ripe for really more, much more massive MIMO to really be intelligent about using beamforming in those types of networks. But of course, sub terahertz is important, and really using intelligent spectrum sharing. We've seen a lot of that over the years. A lot of researchers spend a lot of effort in this area, and hopefully we can see this in 6G. And again, new topologies, right? Really bringing in the satellite networks as part of the designing it in from the ground up for 6G would be great. Clearly for 5G, it was more of an add-on. And also, you know, cell-free, massive MIMO, full duplex, mobile mesh, these are new topologies that we expect to see in 6G. AI and ML is the talk of the town right now in any technological circle. And really, we're talking about trying to infuse this machine learning and artificial intelligence across the entire network end to end. You know, we talked a little bit about the physical layer. I would say that's, you know, we start there, but to the MAC layer, to intelligent scheduling, to the whole network and optimize the entire network and try to see how we can really fully utilize that, you know, in a native manner throughout the network. The next thing is expanded verticals. You hear a lot about metaverse. You don't even, you know, it's always in the news right now. You know, what are these new applications that can really utilize a, you know, low latency, precise location across an entire macro network, you know, or in some cases, maybe localized indoor networks. The next one is optical wireless coalescence. And, you know, in chemistry, coalescence means two things really coming together as one and no longer being separate. And, you know, we've heard a lot of optical wireless convergence really for the past, I would say, 2 to 3 generations, really utilizing fiber optic and wireless technologies to really form the network. Here, we're talking about truly merging these two worlds together. Concepts like all photonics networks, you know, utilizing free space optical communication between satellites in these satellite networks and further using fiber to see how we can utilize that to transport radio signals like radio over fiber. And again, you can't talk about the next generation without talking about security and resilience, right? It's important that we gain the public's trust in these public infrastructure or even in the private infrastructure, you know, increase security requirements there, you know, utilizing zero trust principles. Post-quantum security is something, you know, we're talking about timeframes of 2030 and beyond, right? There's a lot of talk right now on, quantum, obviously quantum computing, you know, rendering a lot of our RSA security kind of, you know, obsolete. And so, you know, we need to start research on thinking about a post-quantum world in terms of security. And last but not the least, you know, end-to-end cloud native, right? One can argue that, you know, 5G is already embracing the cloud, but to the extent of really, you know, utilizing the distributed cloud all the way from the core to the edge, you know, potentially even down to the devices, right? What does that mean from a truly distributed cloud? And again, utilizing the cloud infrastructure also for test and measurement, which is our bread and butter. And again, further disaggregating the network principles like ORAN, and, you know, looking at that into the 6G realm.